Okay, good morning.
Morning.
As I promised, I have copied all the presentations in this USB, but unfortunately, before I came here, I heard that totally altogether we have 18 participants. So I prepared 20. I think it's pretty good. But after I came here, I realized we have more people. More than 20. So I gave it to Anusha, maybe he could assign. For some of the country, maybe if you have more than one person, maybe you get only one. After a while, I will show you the contents in the USB and there are altogether 15 files, and number 15 is a kind of a draft action plan for you to finalize tomorrow afternoon. Okay, today we have quite a few contents, and today's presentation also pretty big. So let's come to that one by one and don't worry and we can come and have a look. And the first one is end-to-end performance and timing customs. Actually, for this kind of a presentation, there should be two. One should be end-to-end, the other one should be timing customs. But since the performance of timing custom is not that complicated, so I put them together. Before this presentation, I also would like to have some questions. Do you check your three labs performance quite often? Do you?
No.
Do you check your three labs performance quite often, day by day, or frequently? This is one question. And second one, what are the main problems for you in three labs performance? In like one lab, two, and three performance. And next question is, do you make automated EDB and the EDC scans? Do you? Yes. Okay. And the last one, are you using EDA scan from time to time?
No.
Are you using that? Not some of you, yes. Some of you, no. Okay. And the presentation consists of two parts, as I told you. The first part is end-to-end performance. And the second one is time in customs. And now, end to end. This is a general situation of the recent, in the recent 3 months of whom? Of Asia Pacific, for our whole region. And you can find the most used indicators generally is on time end to end and the late end to end. In the report or in SMART where you check it, you can find it late end to end. You can find different indicators like late for 1 day, late for 2 days, late for 3 days, or late for more than 3 days in usual. And it consists of three legs, right? On time leg one, on time leg two, and on time leg three. And what I would like to ask now is that for this performance, on time end to end, this is on time end to end for each of our region for outbound or for inbound. Okay. Outbound or inbound? Yeah, we usually we measure your performance for outbound, taking each of you as the origin partner, and then we measure your leg one performance for your export. Your leg one, that's taking yourself as the origin country, and then leg one. So here. The outcome end-to-end is a kind of measurement on your total outbound procedure. So in this procedure, the outcome the leg one is your export. And what about leg two? Your export transport or your import transport? Export. Course, right?
Mm.
Taking yourself as the origin. So we also measure your on-time export as origin. And then now question comes, on-time leg 3, here. This on-time leg 3, leg 3 is which leg?
Delivery.
This is the delivery, leg 3 of yourself or your partner. Yeah. Here for end-to-end performance, if you check end-to-end performance, in leg one, that's your leg one. In leg two, that's your leg two. And for leg three, that's your partner's leg three. In destination country is leg three. So whenever we measure the end-to-end, please be noted. The leg 3 is not your inbound leg 3. The leg 3 here we are talking is your destination leg 3. So some people would like to complain that I can control or I can manage my leg 1. Or maybe I can manage my leg 2. How can I control leg 3? Because leg 3 is perform in your destination partners. So this is also a question, like if you find you have found any problem in your leg one and leg two, you need to try to solve them. And also, if you find any problem or big problem in leg three here, you will try to find in which destination countries this problem happened, and then you can try to negotiate with your partner, with your destination partner. For example, try to find their problem or negotiate with them to improve your performance. Something like no EMD, missed EMD, or late delivery, or any other anomaly. So after a while, I will show you one by one about the performance of your partner and of yourself. Because when we talk something about the problem of others, usually maybe we should concentrate more on the problem on ourselves. So today, for the leg 3 performance, I will talk about something about our destination, your destination performance. the inbound delivery, the left one of yourself, each of us, each of us. Because that's something we need to control, we can control. Okay, this is a kind of end-to-end performance of all of us here in June 2023. Sorry, I feel a bit happy because last night was a long time. But fortunately, we have covered all of us, all of you, 17 operators out here. You can see that the total on time end-to-end in June of each of us, see the performance. We have only a few operators like Indonesia, Cambodia, Laos, Mongolia, Vietnam achieved comparatively better performance, which we call award performance standard, which is 80%. If you achieve the on-time end-to-end over 80%, you achieve award standard. So not so many people could reach that, but one good trend is that I found that in recent months, in our region, I saw more and more operators reaching over 80% because we are doing better and better job, and also many of us are trying to revalidate our standard. I do not mean that you revalidate your standard to make the days longer, but we are trying to make more better and better revalidation because we have made anomaly less and less, lower and lower. Okay, now let's have a look. End-to-end lane, total lane. You see, only some of you suffer big problem like Bhutan. Lane or a bit higher. And Maldi, 12%. And Nauru, 53%. And Papua, and Tonga, and Samoa. The late rate, the rate for late is a bit high. But this is not very stable for especially for islands countries. Islands countries, because you have limited volume. So if you have a few volume, a few items to fill, and the percentage would be pretty high. And left one on time. See, the total end-to-end performance, the on-time left one here, some of you quite high, some of you not that high, or the bottom is very low. The reason for the low performance is not your performance in fact, but it's your enough ASDM. You see, for end to end the total anomaly, it's not only late, but also because of anomaly. See the anomaly problem? That's 59% anomaly. That totally influenced your overall performance. And what is the main anomaly in the name of the sequence? As we talk, it's in the other field. Okay, and next one, China, 51%. What is the main anomaly in China? Mainly lab 2, not late lab 2, but not late lab 2, because you have quite a lot of destination OE which are not included in landfill standard, in transport standard. And okay, let's see another one, Fiji and Indonesia and Sri Lanka. See, Sri Lanka is also pretty high, and this one, because you have too many items used EMA. If you did not make EMA, that's a kind of anomaly, or missing EMA, or no EMA. And the Nauru 20% or 80%. So when you check your home and performance, you need, or you better have a general idea about in which lab your main problems are. And now let's have a look at your performance on each lab. Okay? This is a whole situation about the overall anomaly. As you know, I'm a regional coordinator, and I'm in charge of one of my daily work is to follow your performance. So whenever I found some performance problem, I try to follow. But my focus, for three labs of performance, my focus is not always on late performance. For example, late for one day, late for 2 days, my focus is not on that. My focus is only always on an anomaly, such as no EMA, no EMC, no EMD, no delivery. This is anomaly. This is my focus. And also, in lab one or lab two or in lab three standard, something not included. The post office code is not included in lab one. Or in lab two, some destination OE code are not included. Or in lab three, some of the post offices for delivery are not included, so you have no standard or you have no delivery zone. This is something in my focus, for my focus. So for end-to-end, see, overall anomaly default is 25, and 75, 55, so these top three countries need to obviously, need to improve more. In China, Fiji, Nauru, Papua, you have anomaly of 80 to 81, is about 20%, which is also not good. In Indonesia, well, and some other operators, it's about 8, a bit lower than 10%, which is also should be a focus for you. And the main anomalies I have listed here. No EMA, such as you know. And the incorrect collection point. What is the incorrect collection point? This happened in lab one or lab two or lab three.
Collection point?
Yeah, in lab one. Which means you, in your A scan, you have related post office code, but that post office code is not included in your lab one standard. So we call that incorrect collection point. For lab three, for delivery, if the post office code you use are not included in the delivery standard, we will not say incorrect delivery point. We say no standard. So different expression, similar things. Make it clear. And this anomaly
widely exist among most of us, or among many of us, no destination transport standard from EMD. So for EMD, for level 2 standard, for transport standard, we have mentioned quite a few times that is from C to D. And for EMC scan, you should have the outbound OE code. And for D scan, you should have the destination OE code. And here, this story, no destination transport standard means the destination OE code you are using, you are sending items to, are not included in your transport standard. So that's what I mentioned for China, because they still have this question. For China Post, the percentage is not very high. Maybe it's just 5%. But considering the absolute volume, it's quite high. And it made the whole region, I mean, or to influence the whole region. Okay, this is the end-to-end performance of level 1. For all of you, the export. A more detailed figure, indicator for each of us to find the on-time export. This is on-time level 1. It's here. And the export late, which is level 1, late for level 1. Hopefully, wait here. I did not identify late for 1 day, late for 2 days, late for 3 days. Late for more than 3 days, I did not think that because this is not my focus. This is can be your focus. Anyway, late, rather for how many days. And no EMA, this is my focus. You see, some of you have very high rate for no EMA, like you know, almost 94%. Your total outbound item did not have did not transmit MA and Africa and Fiji and Brunei. The no EMA problem is quite serious. And for some other operators like Bangladesh and this also should be one of your focuses. You need your next step. And you can see that the auto sequence situation in level 1 is quite good. Only Bangladesh. Maybe I made a mistake. I remember. Which is not good. Okay, And the next one, lab 2. In lab 2, because the transport is now one of the most important focus for all of us. And so I leave late for one day, late for 2 days, here so you can have a look. In June of this year, only these operators, China, Indonesia, Laos, Mongolia, Maldives, and Vietnam, they are over, not two, they are over 80% over the world spreader. And the problem for one for late performance are all here. This figure could be used as a reference by all of you. You can see that how many of your items used late and late for how many days. Okay, this is not my focus, as I mentioned. And these two, no EMC. No EMC is a kind of a mistake which would not be forgiven. You need to make complete EMC, otherwise you could not prove that your item was transported out. Okay? So if you have high grade of no EMC, this is really, really a big anomaly question. So from no EMC, we give the next contact with the item, and Nakua 3%, and 3%, and others not higher than 1% compared to weight better. And no destination transport standard. See that China is very low. China is for 13%. 14% for destination OE we are using now are not included in the so a real operation for that group is most necessary now for China most. And another one is the Lapa, 16%. But you do not have a very big influence over your regional containers, but you have big influence on yourself. And another one is Nepal, 90% of your destination. So Nepal obviously has more work to do. You have more than 90% of total outbound item you cannot make a scan. And you have 90% of destination OE code are not included in your level 2 standard. So you have more work to do. And Nauru, 23%. And Papua, 12%. This is also, these are also pretty high. And which means, please make a revalidation for your lab group standard revalidation as quickly as possible to make sure of all the necessary destination OE code should be included. Why this problem exists so widely? One of the reasons should be the pandemic. And there are some factors or some reasons for why we have so widely destination transport standard, because one of the reasons should be because most of you finalized the lab 2 standard during the pandemic. One of the question also happened on me as during the pandemic, one of my focus is to try to push all of us, all members in our region, to finalize all the three next standard validation so that we can finalize, we can realize a kind of target like 100% end-to-end measurement. I would like to do that. And obviously, in Asia Pacific, the situation is not bad because many of us quickly finalize the LAC2 standard validation because LAC2 usually is the last one among the three LACs. So all of you already have delivery standard for many years. And then the next step is LAC1. After you finalize the LAC1, I will push you, finalize LAC2. But during the pandemic, as you know, then you do not have a lot of available air routes. This could be one of the reasons. So in your standard, you have a shortage of a lot of destination OEs because you hopefully do not transport anything to there. But after the pandemic, some air routes resumed. And you still do not have those OE code, those destination OE code. This is a problem. So I found that in our region, it seems we have more problem for no destination transportation standard. So this is another focus for me, I'm trying to follow all countries with this problem. Please do the validation to add in all the destination OE code as complete as possible. Okay, and the next one is the LAC3. Hey, everybody, look, it's the outbound. What does that mean? This is the on-time delivery of yours or of your destination countries. Yeah, destination. This is one part of your one part of your end-to-end, of your export at end-to-end. So this is the performance of delivery of LAC3 of your destinations. So you can have a look at your destination's performance for delivery, which is, I will give you a comparison after this one. See, let's have a look at this one. You see, for Indonesia, Cambodia, Mongolia, and Vietnam, they are obviously your destination operators perform delivery better, and which also helpful for your overall end-to-end performance, right? They help you improve your end-to-end. But for some countries, the destination countries like Bhutan, like Papua, like Nepal, it shows like Fiji, it shows the comparatively not that good delivery performance for which influence your end-to-end overall end-to-end performance. So in this case, if you find more problem, you may try to negotiate. First of all, download Blackwire or easily check it from Smart. You can easily find which destination country or which of your partner give you bad contribution, did not give you good contribution, and you can try to negotiate, try to improve. Okay, let's have a look. The main problem for your destination countries, also one of the main questions is late performance. And among them, some of you experienced more late performance, like here, EKG, and maybe Nabu, maybe Samoa. Late performance is one of the biggest questions in your destination, main destination pocket. And another one is no EMD. If they do not make complete EMD, they have a anomaly, which also influences your end-to-end. So if I were some people from Nauru, I would like to examine maybe Australia or maybe New Zealand. I think your main destination is Australia. All US?
Australia.
Okay. So I think it should be Australia, maybe and ask the question, why not EMD? Why not complete EMD for Australia? They think Australia is not one of the top 10 volume countries all over the world. Their volume increased quite a lot in recent years, especially after the pandemic, and they develop the people. But for them, know this again,
it's quite high.
You pay few for maybe 4 or 5. For you, it's a disaster. For them, maybe nothing. So maybe you can download the platform and try to find the reason why they did not pay with this debt. Or maybe problem happens on your own site. Maybe. So download the platform, analyze. And another one is they have 20% no standard, which means in your delivery, in one of your maybe two destination partners, in that partner, they are using some delivery post office code, which are not included in their delivery standard. So maybe you can negotiate with that country to deliver to use proper delivery post office. So which country is your biggest destination now for the world? Is that India or
USA and Japan? Yeah.
we should find and give him another time. So you remember the suggestion of
EBA.
The question of who will be, you make twice the EB and the EC, and you are still making a lot of performance delivery scan over D, right? If you receive 100 EMD, maybe 100 EMD, and then you make the 99 delivery scan, the provision of delivery info, of course, should be 99%. Right? And this shows the result that after you receive, you make the D scan, and revelations for apps four standard, complete the collection, running office, post office code, and the application for transport standard, collect two standard, for complete the vaccination only code. And the evaluation for next week to complete the delivery protocol. These are really some purposes for most of us. Okay, this is the end about the first part of my first presentation today. It's something about the end-to-end performance. And end-to-end has been very important and has been noticed or paid the more attention by more and more countries everywhere. So now I'm also focusing on end-to-end performance, and not only here, but also in my monthly online meeting. If you join in my meeting, you may know that for each month you can publish something for performance situation. Something like this from all regions in our, from all countries in our region. Okay, and also at the same time, I sincerely hope that all of you would like to follow this performance. And now, second topic, timing customs. As you know, that timing customs the time between which one to which one, between which scan to which scan, how many customs? Between timing customs starting from EDB, right?
Yes.
Ending to
EDC.
Yes.
In the middle, there could be EMB, could be not. Whether you have EME or not, it doesn't matter. But you must have completed EDB and EDC so that the timing customs can be exactly or accurately calculated. And the timing custom can be accurately deducted for your on-time delivery measurement. As you know that we are measuring all of you, the on-time delivery, and in this measurement, the time customs should be calculated, should not be calculated. The condition is that we must make accurate, reasonable, complete EDB and EDC so that this time can be calculated. So this is the situation for all of us who have timing customs in June. See, have a look. Timing customs within 24 hours. This is our performance world standard. If you can reach 80%. You are over 80, you reach the standard. So we have some, most of us reach above standard, like Monet, 100%, you see. 100% of your inbound item analyzed customs within 6 hours. So how do your relationship with customers? Very good. Okay, and look at that. More than almost 100% items could pass the examination within 6 hours. Fiji, Cambodia, Sri Lanka, Mongolia, Bali, pretty good. Not so easy. And in Mongolia, in Mongolia, I remember that I saw once in the early morning how your customs officials kept downloading the items together with the postal staff. which not to be about impression. Because I have another impression of what I saw in Assam, in Indonesia and Assam. Of all the inbound items that the postal staff need to file them in a kind of reform, like a woman, zigzag form, like this at that time. And then the custom official, all in the dark, examining the law three times. Both the dog and the official stepping over the very tiresome work. And then after that, it cost half of an hour. After smelling, examination, dog examination, the modern part of the local items became for further examination. This is one. That would be a very deep impression. Another one in Bangladesh and in Myanmar, and also this time in this year in Berlin, in India, postal staff holding all the inbound parcels one by one to the customs official. And help them to open, to make a list, to register everything inside. And then the custom official gave you a definite answer, like if they need collecting tax or not. And in most of the cases, tax should be needed. So they need to notify the receiver, pay tax, no matter remotely, or come to the OE to pay. And then after they pay the tax, within maybe 1 day, 2 days, or 3 days, or quite a few days, and then the item could be delivered to you. It's very troublesome. That is why, by the end of this presentation, I would like to give you a suggestion to improve this performance. Usually, people would like to say that this performance could not be, but it can, it's possible. Okay, so here, for those countries like, over 74, 72 hours, 4 days, right? 3 days. If the percentage is still high here, you really need to consider all the order of your data scan, or maybe you need to improve the negotiation with customs to make their working efficiency higher. Okay, these are some of the challenges the EMS item custom clearance starting to work, I think. One reason could be EDIMAC not regulated. We are requesting all of us trying to collect as complete EDIMAC message as we can and then send as complete ITMAP data to your destination operators as many as you can, but in actual situation, some of us still could not collect 100% ITMAP data. This is one. And in some countries, maybe you have complete data, but you cannot. Just you know, maybe you do not have a CS, or you do not have a kind of a good system of your own. This could be another reason. And another reason could be some destination country that you use right now. Do you have this? Have you had any situation like this? What about, do you have any, of you, one of your big partners is Singapore? Huh? Are they accepting IBMAP now?
No, Singapore.
Singapore. Quite a few months, I remember that they probably waited up for something. They don't need that. So, if you are, for example, I mean, this story happened in very few countries. For example, one of your big partner, destination partner, they refused to accept that, you know? You got your happy man overseas or something. This is a rather few. I'm so happy to see that more countries are in almost 100% happy matters of data and transmitted to destination or group of destination country. So this could be because of the IP map which follows the slower custom periods in the destination country. In your country. And another could be reason is customs checking inbound items one by one. Like what I've seen in some of the countries, who care for them? But they also they need money, and the country needs money, they need tax. Right? And another reason could be a complicated procedure for clearance. Maybe the clearance procedures too complicated. They need this or that, and sometimes they need a chassis or the origin person, sender, to provide a complete document. And the document is not enough. Provide a complete document or complete e-invoice or something like this. And another reason could be the upgraded DB and DBC scans. Just if you make upgraded DB and DBC, it is very possible to make a complete or repeated DB and DBC scans. In that case, the true time from DB to DBC are not properly calculated. And this is the story in China. Twice EDB and EDC is here. These are two additional questions. And then some steps of suggestive actions, which is the implementation of it is much better if you, from the very beginning, gather or collect complete IPMAP message, because when you make the collecting or when you are making the posting, you already have complete data scan for IPMAP. The only thing is how to collect them and then how to send them to the destination country. And the second one is better communication with customers. This is what we would say for many years, and more reasonable EDB and EDC scans, and the last one, better use of EPA scan. You may consider make a better use of EPA scan. Now let's have a look. Let's have a look. This story or this scenario could be used on the stories that when you receive some inbound items and when the customs told you, they check the items and then they told you these items need a complete document. All these items need tax from the addressee. And in most of the countries, I noticed that from this moment, the item is not 100% controlled by customers because they have notified, they have registered. this, those items which need tax. And the items are still in our hand. In our OE, in our warehouse, and controlled also by postal people. We are waiting there until the address is come, or online, until the payment finalized, we can deliver. So it's totally already totally controlled by ourselves. So in this case, I would like to suggest to you to make a kind of scan procedure like this. When the item is wanted, alright, you make e-scan, right? E-scan, no problem, right?
Yes.
You know what? You make an e-scan. And after e-scan, EDD, send to customs. And then the customs check. And then usually they can quickly let you know which items could go directly, go, which items should be taken. If they depend, usually quite factory way absolutely within 24 hours. Usually within a few hours, maybe 1 or 2 hours, or even a few days, right? So after they decide if the item should be taken, if not taken, just go. So the time between EDD and EDC will be absolutely within 24 hours. But if the items need to be taken, you may make an EMD for the weekend and give appropriate reason why it is taken. Or you do not need to make an EMD because it's just a dependent pass. So you can, at this moment, you may consider this item already finalized the custom clearance because the custom official told you it needs tax. The custom clearance procedure finished, so you make an EDC scan quickly, within 1 or 2 or 3 maximum, in a few hours after the official told you. So you can consider if the items is totally controlled in our hand, so you can consider that the custom clearance finalized. And the next one, immediately after EDC, you make EDA scan. EDA means the item became in OE, in inbound OE, it's not happening. Right? It is in OE. And then for EDA scan, you need to select the proper reason code and the proper action code. So my suggestion for action of the reason code for EDA would be number 21, awaiting payment of charges. Right? This is not cheating. This is something true. Awaiting for charges, awaiting for charges for tax. Waiting for payment for tax, right? And then action code for EDA would be C, customer notified, because we are notifying the addressee to pay tax. So after this EDA scan, you can choose to wait patiently. Because the on-time delivery measurement will not be calculated from here. From EDB to EDC, this time will not be calculated, right? After you make an EDB, the measurement will start. And after you make an EDC, the on-time delivery measurement will start again. But if you make an EDB, it start again until Monday, 2 days, 3 days, no matter how many days, until the addressee paid the tax or or provided complete document, and the item could be released, or maybe it could be delivered, or maybe it could be forwarded or leave the OE to the local post office. And this time you make an EMF. EMF is leaving the OE, right?
Mm.
So if you wait, delivery performance also guaranteed. And most important is that if your our customer tracking this event, tracking this item, he could get very correct, I mean not cheating information about this item. Okay, now the question again. You check your 3 EMS performance quite often.
Do you?
And what are the main problems for you? Now, I think you have a much better idea about your main problems, like incomplete A scan, incomplete C scan, incomplete B scan, incomplete visual scan. And incomplete the destination OE code, incomplete the collecting postal code, post office code, or incomplete the delivery post office code. Okay, and next question, do you make automated delivery scan? If you are making, maybe it will be considered or reconsider your procedure. And are you using EDA scan? You may consider my suggestion. And after this workshop, if any of you are really interested in kind of a better use of EDA, you can also let me know, and so that I can try to finalize your actual situation, individual situation, try to give you a more practical suggestion from my side. Okay? Thanks for this presentation. Question?
Mm-hmm.
More than one time. Why? More than once in the OE. delivery.
Sorry.
In the OE, you make you can use EDA. Now let us do it again. For inbound item, first of all, EMD, right?
Yes.
After EMD, usually EDB. You send it to customs. And the custom official told you, hey, this one should be again in the warehouse until the addressee come, pay the tax, and they made a registration, maybe how much tax they should pay. And then at this time you can consider, you may consider the custom clearance finalized. So agree for EDC, finalized, and then immediately after this EDC, you make the EEA. And to say that this item is retained in OE, and still remember the reason code, awaiting payment of the charges, and action code for customer notified. You notify the customer to pay tax, right? And after they pay, it might be delivered in the OE. If it's delivered in the OE, you make the EMF, and then immediately EMI. If it is delivered in the OE. But if it is not delivered in OE, after EDA, still EMF, leave the OE. And it will be which one? To the post delivery post office? EMG, usually. EMG arrived to the delivery post office. And then in the delivery post office, you may experience the same story again. In some countries, the tax maybe does not necessarily pay here, but pay here in delivery post office. So if the story happened in the delivery post office, as soon as you make an EMG, you make an EDF. EDF means detained in the delivery post office, not detained in the OE. And when you make EDF, please remember, select the reason code, same reason code, awaiting payment for charges, and same action code, customer notified, because you are doing the same thing. And this item needs to grab text. And so you need to let the addressee know. And you notify the addressee come, and they pay tax, you deliver, right?
Yes.
No matter how many days after you deliver, you directly make an EMI. This is the suggested procedure. In that case, if the scenario is like this, then the time between here from EDB and EDC will not be calculated, will be deducted for on-time delivery measurement. And then the time between EDA and EMF will also be deducted, will not be calculated. And in this scenario, the time between EDF to EMI will be deducted, will not be calculated for on-time delivery. So if you make a reasonable scans, if you put, within a reasonable order, a good order, you can obviously improve your on-time delivery performance. And at the same time, we provide customer reasonable, complete, and practical information.